see that many people. Man, my beard is growing. That's great. Anthony was the one that he's telling me, you know, shave your beard, shave your beard.
Yeah.
Oh, and you shaved it for him?
Yeah.
I thought maybe you lost a bet or something.
No, 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 I just shaved it.
I'm just kidding.
No, 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 it's okay, it's okay. No, pues estos son los que se quedan aquí. Como esos no son tus típicos inmigrantes normales, ¿sí ves? Mm-hmm. How's everybody doing? Good afternoon to everybody. Hi. Thank you so much, Miss Betty. How you doing, Miss Robin? It's a really sunny day over here in Tijuana. Good afternoon, I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. How you doing? Hello, Miss Winona Gomez. Miss Carl Davis. Miss Mary Golden, how you doing? So, this is a really, really nice day today in Tijuana. The weather is real nice. I don't know actually how which is the 100 degrees or Fahrenheit, but you know, it's really nice because I have visitors all the way from North Dakota, from the borderline. It's the borderline, right? Over there?
Basically
the borderline. So here in the back is right there is Cindy. How you doing, Cindy? Say hello to everybody.
Hey everyone, we're out here with Oscar El Blue Ramirez, and he is showing us the town. He's already taken us to a whole bunch of shelters. We already saw the place where people crossed into the United States, the mass crossing that happened, we've just gotten started, so there will be more updates very soon.
And here is Duke, right
here. Hello, in Tijuana. In Oscar's car. I can't believe it. Never thought this would ever happen, but it's happening.
It's happening.
This is great.
So we are about to go to, one of the persons that Cindy talks to a lot is Pastor Alberto. We are going to Pastor Alberto's shelter right now, so Cindy can actually talk to him and, you know, give you guys information of what is going on at his particular shelter. Probably we're going to talk to this minors that they already testified against, the guy from Guatemala. And we're going to talk to him and talk to these miners and see what kind of information they can give us. And after that, we are going to go to take a little walk to where all these Antifas and all these organizations are sitting at and they are stationed at. And we're going to see a pair of hotels, from where are they probably, renting and living. So I'm gonna ask a question to Cindy. Cindy today, she had a big conference today. She had a big conference confronting. I don't like to use the word confronting, but she tried to talk to one of the lawyers from Al Otro Lado, that is Nicole Ramos. And I will let the feed to Cindy. Cindy, how was that? And can you explain to everybody, that what Nicole Ramos actually tried to avoid every single question that you were right there trying to ask her?
Yeah, so here's what happened, guys. So I told you we were gonna go live from inside, and we tried to. In fact, I had asked Professor Guadalupe Correa Cabrera if she would allow us to go live, and she said, of course, yes. And of course we paid. Duke and I paid over $300 to be inside, to ask questions, to be part of the event. So we expected fully that was going to happen. And there was two people that were going to be presenting there. There was a person that was announcing the speakers, Nicole Ramos, and then the second person was Dulce, oh my God, I just forgot her last name. But she is a lawyer. She's an undocumented immigrant living in the United States who is a lawyer working with Border Angels. and I recognized her.
She lives in the United States.
How come
she gets that benefit and I don't?
She has a practice there.
What the hell's going on?
Yeah. And so, along with us was also two San Diego residents that have been providing a lot of information about what's going on there, Melinda Oporto and Amy Sutton. And we were all ready with our questions. They came in, they saw us, and then they went over to the guy that was going to introduce them. There was also another lady that was a moderator. They went over to these two people and they started pointing us out. They pointed at Duke, they pointed at me, they pointed at Amy, they pointed at Melinda. And then the man got up and made an announcement. He said, "We're going to start very soon, and there will be no videotaping allowed. We want you to put away all your devices, turn off all your devices. There will be no videotaping allowed." And he said, somebody asked why, of course. And he said, "Because we have two activists here." Suddenly they became activists. A minute ago they were lawyers, now they're activists. They're like, "We have two activists here."
She was referring to you?
No, she was referring to the people speaking. The lawyers, Nicole Ramos and the other lawyer. That's who she was. They call them,
that's, not activists, are
I know, they're lawyers. And that's how they're protecting them. Get a load of this. This is how much the people at this conference were ready to protect these two women. At the Hyatt. At the Hyatt, a very, very fancy hotel. I did a little live stream outside. You can't even see the top of the building. And so the professor was one of the people that asked the moderator, why are you doing this? Because she had just come out of a different panel. I sat in on part of that and I watched the interchange. There were people asking questions. Some of them were not even raising their hands. And there was interactions between the people and the panelists where they would ask follow-up questions. They would even sometimes contradict the person. But isn't this also true? And it was an exchange of ideas. The people Okay, we're back. And then when we went into this other one, we were told we can't film. So the professor asks, why are you doing this? This is not being done anywhere else. And I've never seen this before. Remember, this is a professor that is part of the academic group that forms this conference. And she was the president of the conference last year. So she knows very intimately how all of this is organized and how all of it is done. And she said it was unprecedented that they would not allow people to film or record anything. So then,
they were not expecting you, by the way, probably.
When they saw me, they were like, "Point them out, get them out of here." And so of course I was still going to ask a question, and I asked my question, and I knew how she was going to try to avoid answering my question. I thought about three different questions I was going to ask if I got the chance, and I knew that there was a high likelihood I would probably only get one. So I focused on which was the most important question that I wanted to get her on the record for. And that question was, I asked a two-part question, which I thought was genius. First part of my question is, since you are aware of the immigration policies under Obama and under Trump, as you have explained them, what is your success rate for getting asylum for these asylum seekers that you are bringing? Because this caravan movement is unprecedented in terms of asylum history. So how many people, and if you don't have numbers yet, what is your projected goal for the numbers of people who will gain asylum? The second part of my question is, the second part of my question is, what responsibility do you, as Al Otro Lado, your organization, and Border Angels, and the other groups that you're working with, have to the people who you brought into this country to follow up on their success or what they're doing? She couldn't answer either one of those questions. Actually, she did answer the second one. The second one is, we don't know where they go and we have no control over what happens to them.
Oh,
she
oh my God.
She admitted that.
She said that?
Yeah, she admitted it.
So,
yeah.
Oh
my God.
I have it on the record. I got it on the record. And, by the way...
These people are really... Before you say something...
Sure.
Cindy, these people are really... really stupid when they answer really. I'm so sorry for the word, but they are really stupid. Like the one that I confronted, and we're not doing that anymore. How in the hell? Man, they're really something, huh?
Oh, well, yeah, let me tell you why. Okay, this is what I've realized. These folks are puppets, and I don't mean that in a derogatory way, like, oh, they're dumb and they can just be manipulated. I mean it like the people that actually manipulate the puppet strings, that actually pay them, that actually are the ones organizing this campaign, those people tell them what to say. These folks that are speaking on their behalf in the leadership of these organizations are merely the mouthpiece for their propaganda. So she has a script and she reads off of the script, and somebody gave her some acting lessons, not very well, but they did. And so she tells her story. She knows it. They put her on this tour where she's going to universities. She's going to some of the top universities in the United States. She was just speaking at Harvard Law.
What?
Harvard Law.
Harvard
Law.
Yes.
Oh, you can't even believe the stuff that you can't even believe the stuff that they're doing. But anyway, she will be knocked off her script if she's asked something that they haven't practiced answering. If they haven't practiced figuring out the answer, what do you say when they ask you this question? They don't know what to do. So, the first thing that I knew she was going to do was say what all of the American activists that have been here in Tijuana have been parroting, because I have been watching those people now ever since they got here, and I've heard all of their videos where they're teaching people, where they're coaching people about how to request asylum, how they're requesting money for the people that are here, for the minors that they're hiding in these underground apartments that they're keeping these minors in. And they were saying this, we don't know the number of people that are going to get asylum, but it varies from place to place in the United States. Can you believe that? It depends on where you live. If you have your asylum claim in a place like New York, you're much more likely to get asylum than if you live someplace like, you know, and they started going through, right? The different places where you can get better asylum. And I'm like, what are they doing? And what they were trying to do was change the number in the national average of the number of people that get asylum. Trying to claim that there are some places where you just get lucky and you just get asylum, which is not true. So I was waiting for her to start down the road. And the minute she did, I said, let me clarify my question. And what I was going to say, and what I did eventually say, was, what you're talking about is the fact that there are pockets of certain groups of immigrants living in certain parts of the United States that are more likely to get asylum because of the country they come from. Like, for example, Cuba. And she's like, oh yeah, that's correct.
Oh my God.
And also she added, and also Africans.
How old is Nicole Ramos?
I don't know. She looks really young. She looks pretty young.
This is too much for her.
She's
like, it's too much of a big of a package for her. And you're right, they're using her as a puppet, you know, because she's the only one that is taking the heat for all these accusations. And she's inexperienced to answer, really. She's really inexperienced. What she said to over here when she came to a conference, she called out every organization from Tijuana racist. Mm-hmm. How can you tell people from Tijuana that they're racist? First of all, and who are you that you don't even live over here to call everybody racist and then go back to the United States and then live over there? Like, oh yes, I just call everybody racist. No, I think that is too much for her, because she's looking really bad in every conference.
Oh, I agree.
She can't be avoiding all those kind of questions, although.
No, they can't avoid them forever. And so the minute I started to ask her that follow-up, you know, I said, I want to clarify. The moderator lady jumped on me like an attack dog. And she was like, excuse me, ma'am, you're interrupting. You can't do that. And I said, I am clarifying my question so that she can answer it. Because she wasn't going to answer the question. And then when I clarified it, she still didn't answer it. She never answered the question. She went off on a tangent and started talking about how other countries let people have asylum for things like domestic violence and gang violence, but the United States doesn't. And that's not fair.
It's impossible. They're not, they're trying to put one, and I think that this is, you know, everybody knows that. It's so exhausting saying the same thing, dude. It's just, they're trying to put the same immigration laws, one immigration law for the whole world.
Right.
That's what they're trying to do.
Yeah.
And you know, the United States cannot have that. It's a first class world country. You cannot put immigration laws for a fourth class world country exactly for the first class world country. It is not. You have to fight for the possibilities to migrate. That's what they want to put as much weak as the immigration laws in every country. And it's not, she's crazy, really. She's really crazy, man.
But let me tell you something. I've seen all of this before with Standing Rock. They did this before. And you would watch all of these people go on these panel discussions on The Intercept, and they would go on these panel discussions on news, and they would go on these panel discussions at universities, and they would say all these crazy things, and you were thinking, like, how do they think they're going to win? They also sued the president. They also sued Trump. And that was the goal, to get money for the lawsuit. It doesn't matter if you're going to win the lawsuit. You get money because you're going to sue Trump. And they're counting on the people that hate Trump to put money up for that lawsuit. Yeah, it's true.
They're really smart. To take money, they're really smart.
Oh, yeah.
They're really smart. So, eventually, she didn't answer none of your questions.
No.
So, this is the thing that is really nice. You, after the whole thing finished, you went up to her and you asked her for an interview.
Yep, right away in front of everyone.
So, what happened?
So, I thought, okay, I'm going to put her on the spot because these people did not want her to look embarrassed. So, I'm going to make her agree to an interview. She's not going to say, no, I'm not going to talk to you. There would be no reason. I was very professional and incredibly polite. I even thanked her. I did. I said, thank you very much for giving us all of the information about your organizations and your roles within them. And I truly am thankful that she gave me all of that information, because you should hear the things that she said. It's going to be very interesting when I am able to get back and share everything that they talked about, both Border Angels and her. And there were some infuriating things in there. Like, for example, I almost lost my cool when she started talking about how, so each of them had a sad story they were gonna tell, and a moment when they were going to try to cry, and they were gonna get really, really serious and cry, so you felt like they had the moral superiority. And anybody that questioned what was happening.
60 million Mexicans in poverty are not as sad as a story in our country. Yeah. So you got to bring some more sad stories so you will get your point across.
And each one of them had the sad story to tell, right? So,
oh my God.
And so Nicole says, let me tell you a story. And I'm like, okay.
Once upon a time.
This is an but listen, Oscar, this is how they train you in organizing. I know, because I was trained. I was trained by the same people that trained these people. So I understand how they work and what they're doing. And in fact, that particular training on the sad story came out of Harvard University.
Wow.
I am not joking. I think I might still have the material somewhere. Point is, she starts telling her story, and the story is the story of the two kids, the two teenagers who were, because of the activists, sleeping in the streets in front of Benito Juarez, and then got lured off to some prostitute's place and got beaten, tortured, and killed.
That was not the story. That is not the actual story. And I know the actual story because I know the people that told me the story, actually how it went. These kids had a big fat check that it was sent by their family members from the U.S. These kids, like I just showed you, the shelter was a few blocks away from Prostitution Street.
Yep.
So what they did was they cashed in the check and they went in to get a prostitute.
Right.
Now over here, if you look foreign and if you look like you have money, it's a risk that you're going to take. You
right.
don't even know who you are in the room with.
Right.
So probably they asked them to give them the money without a service, and they got into it with them,
mm-hmm.
and they got killed.
Mm-hmm.
That is the reality of the story. They're trying to put something, they got torture, and they got, oh man, who's going to waste their time on two young kids to get tortured? They're nobody. If they were like big, business guys, that they have millions and millions of dollars, they will waste that time. But they are not. They have like, I don't know, probably $200 on them or $300 on them. That was it. So it's just, it's a lie.
And you told me this story before. So part of me, when she was telling her whole story, I wanted to change my question. I was like, oh my God, this is making me so angry. I need to correct her. But then I went, nope, Cindy, stick with your question. You're only going to get one question. So that was the question I did. That was the question I used. Is this the spot?
Yes, this is the spot.
Okay. So, all right, guys. I think that we are going to end this live stream now.
Yes.
Because we got to go in and interview the pastors. So I guess I'll be seeing you maybe on my own live stream in a bit. Okay? Bye.
Say bye, dude, to everybody.
Catch you later.
So, hi. I will be still live. Let me just... I'm not going to be like that to the public. They want to see what's going on. They want to see what's going on. You guys want to see what's going on, right?
Okay.
So, let's just continue to be live. And hold on a second. Bear with me, people, because I am going to get my gimbal.
That's all
right. Le traje el teléfono a una muchachita aquí. ¿Qué onda con ustedes, pues? Pues ya los hacía en Canadá. No, es que ¿saben qué? La abogada vive en Fresno. Pero ahorita hablamos si quieren. ¿Sale?
Look at him with his stabilizer.
Yes. Right here. Let's go. Vámonos.
See, I need one of those things, dude.
Let's walk in again to the shelter right here with the pastor. And I'm not going to say anything till the... No. So, let's go. Buenas tardes. Buenas tardes. These are old rooms. These are where the miners are, Cindy.
Okay.
Right here. He's gonna show you later on. You don't even imagine how big it is over here. Okay. On this part, right here. This one. This is a kitchen that it was donated from, I don't know what organization, from America.
Okay.
Let's go.
Gerardo, ven.
Buenas tardes. ¿El pastor está? Buenas tardes. ¿Está el pastor? Étale, ¿cómo está? Ahí está.
¿Cómo estamos?
Pastor.
How are you?
Qué gusto de conocerte.
Good.
Mi esposo, dude.
Oh, good. Great.
¿Cómo estamos?
Good.
Muy bien, gracias a Dios.
Pues nos hizo el favor de ir a recogernos y a traernos. Estoy aquí, pastor.
Qué bueno.
Le dije que venía.
Wow.
Para que me dé.
How many hours?
We flew, was it 3.5 hours? And then just took a few minutes to get over the border.
Pues aquí tenemos el internet de los niños.
Okay.
He's going to show them again, the whole thing. You guys already saw this. But my whole thing right now, to be on the live stream with you guys, is to eventually talk to the miners. I want to talk to the miners that they were molested, or in a way, they were offered sex to cross illegally to the United States by this Guatemala guy by the name of Nicolas Esteban. That's my whole purpose right here to come over here. My whole purpose to come over here is to, as you guys already saw this is the computer station and all that. My whole purpose to be over here, hello, buenas tardes? To be over here is to interview the miners. So just for you guys to know, when I interview the miners, I'm not going to be able to record their faces, only from the neck down. So I'm going to be asking them questions, and ¿qué onda contigo? ¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo te va? No los veo que todavía se vayan. ¿Qué onda? ¿Cómo van?
No, te veo, aquí estamos.
¿Sí?
Sí.
¿Y qué onda? ¿Sí están propuestos para la Canadá o no?
Pues primeramente Dios, de hecho no sabemos, no sabes tú nada sobre
eso. Sí, tengo una abogada, pero es que la abogada vive en Fresno. Piden freno, pero si ¿sí te quieres lanzar para allá?
Sí.
¿Sí? ¿Me das un minuto nada más? Okay. ¿Un poquito? Sí.
Por aquí voy a estar jugando.
No, pero aquí poquito. ¿Sí? Okay. ¿De dónde vienes, amigo?
De Honduras.
I'm asking him, where is he coming from? And he's saying from Honduras. So, the question that I want to ask you is that, do you think that is a better possibility, if there's a better possibility to go to Canada instead of the United States, will you go to Canada? La pregunta que te quiero hacer ahorita en estos momentos, si tú piensas que sería una mejor posibilidad de riesgo, de no arriesgar tanto en ir mejor a Canadá que a Estados Unidos, ¿a dónde preferías ir?
Sería Canadá.
A Canadá.
Ajá.
So he's saying that Canada. Did you already investigated a little bit about migrating to Canada? ¿Has investigado algo a parecer de cómo migrar a Canadá?
Pues la verdad todavía no tengo mucha información sobre eso.
Pero ya saben que sí pueden migrar para
allá.
I already told him that he's telling me that that he already knows that he can migrate to Canada, but he doesn't know the possibilities of migrating to Canada. But his whole perception is to migrate to Canada. So Canadá es una opción muy fuerte para ustedes.
Yes. Sí.
Okay. Voy a tratar de traer una abogada para en las siguientes semanas. Ella vive en Fresno, se llama Berta Aguirre, y les va a venir a decir cómo ustedes pueden ir a Canadá. Okay.
Okay.
I've just told him that there's going to be a lawyer coming and give a conference for them to know how to, if they want to migrate to Canada, go to Canada. Okay. Ándale, pues, mi amigo. Sale, ya dijo. Ándale. Ahorita lo miro.
Okay.
So this is you guys already know. How's everything over here? We've been here with Paloma, with Ben, and Ant, and Arizona Patriots, and I've been here alone. You guys already know how it is over here. That was the whole shelter over here. And apparently right now, there's a big amount of miners that the pastor has. And the miners that he has is around 35 to 40. That's what he said. That's what I understood. I think it's between 25 and 40. So I will wait for Cindy to finish with the pastor, and I will interrupt them in a few minutes. And no los voy a grabar. No se preocupen, no los voy a grabar. I will wait for Cindy to finish up, and after that, I think this is one of the miners right here, but I don't know if she wants me to interview her after. Let me see.
Let me see if.
¿Cómo estás?
Estoy parada.
¿Sí? ¿Te puedo hacer unas preguntitas? ¿Sí? ¿Te pueden mostrar en la cámara o no?
No.
No, ¿verdad? De aquí para abajo.
No, dame cuando quiero grabarme, ¿verdad?
No, 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 de aquí para abajo.
No.
Nomás de aquí para abajo.
Yo ahora no quiero que me grabes. No, 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 jugar, pero,
es que lo que quiero preguntarte es, ¿a ti se te ofreció este hombre?
Ah, ya vi.
Sí.
Pues a mí no, pero me van a hacer.
Okay, nomás, mira, de aquí para abajo, te lo prometo.
Pero es que no
te lo prometo. Mira, ahí va.
Ni aquí para abajo, ni acá para arriba, ni nada.
Ahí está, de aquí.
Espérate, pero es que no quiero que veas las preguntas, ¿eh?
Ok, ahí está.
Esto, so, te estás diciendo que no quieres que veas las preguntas.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¡Ey, te estoy!
Ya le hago. Ven. Más un poquito, nomás poquito.
Ay.
So, this is what, ¿cómo te llamas?
Xiomara.
Xiomara. This is Xiomara. ¿Cómo, cuánta edad tienes?
13.
She is 13 years old. And she is the one that, one of the minors that this Guatemala guy offer her sister. ¿Cuántos años tiene tu hermana?
15.
Her sister, she has 15 years old. And this Guatemala guy offered her sister to cross her to the United States in exchange for sex. ¿Qué fue lo que pasó con tu hermana? ¿Qué, cómo se le ofreció este hombre y qué fue lo que hizo?
Bueno, pues el hombre nada más se le ofreció de la manera que vino él. Le dijo que también se podía ir con ella y que él la iba a cruzar y todo eso.
¿Pero a cambio de qué?
Pues primero le dio, a la muchacha le dijo que le iba a cobrar. Pero después resultó eso, que no les iba a cobrar dinero, sino que con...
Que se acostara con él.
Ajá.
Eso es lo que dijo.
Sí.
¿Cuántas? That's basically what she's saying is that first, the guy told him that she was going to charge him, and then later on, he offered her an exchange for sex. Ya, ya es todo. Ya para que te vayas. Okay. Ya para que no tengas vergüenza. Ya es todo. There you go. That's her. She's really embarrassed to talk. She's 13 years old, guys. She's 13 years old. She's a really nice lady. You know, she's young, guys. She's 13, and you know, she was really nice last time to talk to me. But it's so unfortunate to hear those stories. To hear these stories right here. And I will show you who she is so you guys can see who she is right here. That's the one in blue. Right here. That's her. That's her, the one in blue. So here comes the pastor. She's talking with Cindy right here. And eventually, you know, we're gonna take the same trip. We're gonna take the same trip as last time.
I have had up to 200.
But this is one of the stories that she was one of the minors that gave a declaration to the human rights, that this disgusting guy from Guatemala asked her sister, that she's 15 years old, to have sex with her in exchange to cross her to the United States. Now, you heard it from her own voice, and she doesn't want to be on camera. She's too embarrassed, and I believe she's overwhelmed on being on camera with the same subject. So she just, you know, she just gave me a story, and she was really nice of her to talk to me. She's 13 years old, imagine that. So we're in the same, you know, place as we were right here with Paloma and Ben. And now Cindy and Duke are right here. And Cindy has a great relationship with the pastor. And we're just, they're just, the pastor is exactly like he show Ben and he show Duke.
And then I have also the two minors.
Okay.
Two minors, one of them is...
Pastor, ¿habrá la posibilidad de hablar con la menor de los 15 sin mostrarle la cara?
Yeah.
¿Sí?
Yeah.
I just asked him, the pastor, if there's a possibility for me to talk with the minor, that she's 15 years old, so she can give a quick statement for us of what happened basically with this Guatemala guy that is on the loose, that his name is Nicolas Esteban, and that his guy, you know, this guy practically... In exchange for crossing legally to the United States, this guy was asking these minors to have sex with him. So you just heard the sister of the 15-year-old say to us the declarations of that eventually, yes, he offered you know, the 15 year old too, to have sex with him in exchange for sex. We have a lot of instruments right here. Reminds me when I was young. And we have one beautiful flag right here. This is one beautiful flag. This is my flag. My flag. One beautiful flag right here. Beautiful. Beautiful right here. And let's hear the pastor right now as he's talking to Cindy and Duke. Let's see what kind of questions Cindy has. And let's hear the feed, everybody, to hear what the declarations of the pastor right now in exchange and talking about these subjects.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go live and...
Let me get the girls for a second.
That's okay. They're coming, right? Or you still have to go get them?
I need to make sure that I get them.
Okay, go ahead and go and get them.
Gracias, pastor. Gracias. Okay, so the pastor is going to get the two minors. Okay. The two minors. What age is considered underage in Mexico and Honduras? Under 18. Under 18 is considered underage. So 17 is underage. 17 to... 17 and under, it's under age, and this is the type of declarations that is really important for everybody to hear, everybody to know, and this kind of questions that we're about to ask these minors are really deep and really powerful. Why? Because it's an experience that probably they're going to remember for the rest of their lives. They're running away from violence and delinquency, and now Cindy, they are, basically this guy asked them for sex in exchange to cross to the United States. Isn't that disgusting?
Did you have a chance to talk to them already?
No, the one that is 13. Yes, I just interviewed her.
Okay, so did I watch your live stream? Is that what I was watching?
No, just when, right now. Right
no,
now.
Oh, before did you know about this new kidnapping?
No, when I came over here, even we met the guy.
You did?
Yeah, and I shook his hand. Yes.
Whoa.
Yes, he was right here, and he's on the live stream.
The guy that he was
trafficking people, and he was,
sleeping with kids.
Yes.
Because I mean, he's doing it.
Yes. Yes, of course.
What's going on, honey?
So yes, this is.
Keys for a second. I just got
to... You forgot something?
I have to get my phone.
What's in your phone?
I'm just going to record it.
You're going to record it with your phone?
Yeah.
What?
Unlock and lock, or whatever it is.
What if I just use my data?
So, hello? ¿Cómo están? ¿Bien? ¿Cómo se llaman?
Leslie.
La estoy volteando para allá. No, para allá. No, la cámara, yo la estoy volteando para allá. ¿Cómo están?
Leslie.
Que la salude con la izquierda. ¿Cómo está Karen? ¿De dónde son? Ah, mira qué bien. Okay. So, yes, basically, this is it. We're about to interview the minors that they were offered sex with this Guatemala guy in exchange to cross illegally to the United States. Blue, don't show their faces. Yes, I will not. When I'm interviewing them, no. Afterwards, if they're far away, I can record, and that's it. But in their interview, no. So,
how do you have service in here, Oscar?
I don't know. It's because my phone is Mexican. There's privileges, Cindy.
Damn it. I cannot get a
welcome to my country,
How are you doing this?
So here we're gonna sit down and talk. We're gonna sit down and talk. No les voy a grabar la cara, pastor. La menor, ¿quién es la menor?
Ella es la menor.
Okay.
Ella
es la menor.
La cara.
No, nadie la cara. So everybody, I'm not going to record the face apparently right now. So I'm just going to record from the bottom down. Oh, right here. Miren, para que vean cómo se mira el video. Asómate. Para que vean, mire. ¿Ya ves cómo se mira? Nomás estoy mirando tus pies. Mira. Ahí está. Tus pies nada más.
¿Si quieres ver?
Para que veas, mira. No estoy, mira. Ok. Y este es. Ok.
Nada más para que se escuche.
¿Puedo? Esperamos.
Si quieres empieza, yo voy a empezar a grabar.
Okay. We're gonna start. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Leslie.
First one that I asking her, what's her name? Her name is Leslie. ¿Qué edad tienes?
27 años.
She's 27 years old. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Karen Lucero.
Karen Lucero is her name. ¿Qué edad tienes?
25.
25 años, 25 years old. And the last one, ¿cómo te llamas?
Xiomara.
Xiomara. And how old are you? ¿Qué edad tienes?
13.
13 años. Todas las tres son de Honduras, ¿verdad?
No, es de El Salvador.
El Salvador. Oh, so the minor, right here, she's from El Salvador, Honduras, and Honduras. Okay.
We have another minor that's on the way. That's coming.
Okay, no, there's another. There.
Just, yeah, she's the
15-year-old.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so, okay, there's a fit. The 15-year-old, yes.
Okay.
Yes, okay. Cindy's gonna translate for me. So, the question that I wanna ask first, this one. Ella también fue con lo del este señor.
Ella la testigo, la que recibió. Ella puede decir que cuando pasó, qué fue lo que pasó, y a ella le mandaron el dinero. Le mandaron el dinero para una para la que se escapó o alguien que se escapó.
So I want to ask you. Ya te va a traducir, ¿okay? I want to ask you.
You can't.
What happened, and how long is this guy been trafficking people in this shelter?
No, tú en español y okay. Yo en inglés.
Ah, okay. Lo que te quiero preguntar es. ¿Qué es lo que está pasando? ¿Qué fue lo que pasó? ¿Y cuánto tiempo este hombre ha estado haciendo este tipo de negocio aquí en este albergue?
Que
ustedes han dado cuenta.
That you know of.
Pues desde que yo llegué aquí en el 16 de febrero.
I arrived on the 14th of February, 16th of February.
Sí, desde que yo llegué aquí el 16 de febrero, cuando yo llegué aquí por primera vez, me dijeron que
Since I arrived from the beginning.
Me dijeron que él podía
llevarme
al lugar donde podían tirarme para el otro lado. Entonces yo dije que yo iba a esperar primero a ver qué pasaba. Me quedé unos días más. Dejé que pasara el tiempo. A los días se vino mi amiga, Gaby, y estuvimos aquí platicando y todo. A los días me dijo una de mis compañeras de cuarto que ellas se iban a tirar. La niña, la menor de edad, que es la china, ella fue la que le dijo a otras dos que se fueran, que las iba a llevar el señor Chapín para el otro lado.
Chapín es
from Guatemala.
Guatemala. She told me that the Chapín, which is the man from Guatemala, was going to take her to the location where she could jump.
The coyote. He's the coyote.
Yeah, and the guy that she's talking about is the coyote. The Chapín,
okay,
which she says is Chapín, is coyote.
¿Recibiste tú alguna vez una instrucción de agarrar algún dinero de él, de cobro o algo así?
Did you ever receive any instructions from him that you were going to pay him or charge him?
No, yo no, yo una vez recibí nada de él.
I didn't receive anything
from
him.
Sino que simplemente la muchacha que se escapó cuando
the girl that escaped,
se fueron, ella era amiga mía, por en medio de mí se comunicó la tía de ella para poderle ayudar para que regresara
and
de vuelta para Honduras.
Her aunt contacted me to try to help her go back to Honduras.
Okay. ¿Por cuánto tiempo tú, alguna vez te ofreció a ti también para poder cruzar hacia los
Did
Estados Unidos?
Offer you an opportunity
sí, una
to
vez me dijo que él me podía llevar nada más a mí y a mi hijo y yo le
Just
dije
me and my
que
son,
no.
And I said no.
Que
I don't
no.
¿Y cuánto fue lo que él te cobraba por cruzar?
Well, how much was he charging
no,
you to
solo
cross?
Me dijo que ocupaba 500 pesos.
500
pesos para los pasajes porque había que pagarle a alguien más para cruzar.
Had to pay somebody else to cross us.
¿Estás bien? ¿Sí?
Sí.
Sí, se ve como que te sientes mal. Si te sientes mal, está bien.
No, estoy bien.
¿Sí? ¿Segura?
Ah,
oh, bueno, hombre. Te estoy viendo como que quieres llorar y yo estoy acá preocupándome. ¿Estás bien?
No, lo que pasa es que está aburrido.
Sí, sí. No, pues le voy a meter intensidad entonces, ¿no? ¿Cómo te sientes tú ahorita después de toda esta experiencia con esta persona?
No, pues
con miedo, con temor.
With fear.
Tengo temor.
I'm afraid. A lot of. I'm very scared.
Porque piensas que este hombre va a tomar represalias en contra de ti.
Do you think that he's going to try to
sí,
do something
cuando,
to you?
Sí, porque cuando el pastor lo sacó de aquí, que el pastor se dio cuenta todo de lo que estaba pasando. Nosotros fuimos a la delegación, incluso yo no quise dar mi declaración en la delegación porque me dio temor. Tuve miedo, no lo quise hacer.
I was so scared I couldn't give a declaration of what he did to me.
Okay. ¿Te vienes para acá? Para que...
Can you want to switch spots so that...
Para no...
So that... Okay. I'm going to ask you some questions too, if you don't mind. Yo también te quiero hacer algunas preguntas si no te interesan. Si no te importa.
Okay.
Ahí se pueden poner. You go first, and then I'm going to question them.
Okay.
Tú primero.
Déjame nada más desde aquí. ¿Cómo te llamas tú?
Karen Lucero.
Karen Lucero. ¿Qué edad tienes?
How old are you? 25.
25.
Sí, eres de Honduras, ¿verdad?
Are you from Honduras? Yes.
Sí. ¿Qué experiencia tú tuviste con este persona de nombre Nicolás Esteban?
Pues cuando yo lo conocí a él.
Espérame. Okay.
Cuando lo conocí a él, que el día que llegué al albergue, aquí a la iglesia Ágape, él se ofreció bien amistoso, como que él era el encargado de todo aquí. Entonces, luego con los días me fue brindando él su amistad y me fui llevando bien con él. Ya los días él me dice para qué yo voy a esperar un número, si él me puede cruzar a mí. Entonces yo le dije que me daba miedo porque ando yo con mi bebé. Luego
¿qué edad tiene tu bebé?
3 años.
Okay. Do you want to translate any of that so far?
No, tú, pues tú.
Okay. So she told me that she says that when she first got here, this guy, the coyote, was very friendly with her and he acted like he owned the place, like he was the guy that managed the place. And with time, she became more friendly with him. And finally, he said to her, why are you waiting around for your number when I can cross you? And then I asked her how old her baby was. She said she was scared because she was with her baby. And I asked her how old her baby was. And she said 3.
Okay. ¿En qué tiempo él se te ofreció a ti para que tú cruzaras hasta los Estados Unidos? I'm asking her at what time and how long ago this guy offered himself for you to cross to the United States.
Yo vine el 8 de febrero y ya como a la semana de estar yo aquí, él se ofreció en llevarme.
I came on the 8th of February and about a week after I got here, he offered to cross me.
Pero sin embargo, cuando yo le dije a él de que no, había un grupo de gente que ya él ya había, como que ya él ya la tenía lista ya para llevársela.
So he already had a group of people that were ready. I said no to him, but he already had a group of people he was preparing to cross, so.
En ese momento yo estoy indecisa porque luego de, había una pareja en mi cuarto donde ellos iban con él y ya ellos decían de que él les había dicho que solo iban a caminar 2 horas, que rápido iba a ser todo.
So I was kind of undecided. I wasn't sure if I wanted to go, but there was a couple that was staying in my room with me that had already talked to him, that already made arrangements to go with him, that told me that he had already told them that they were only going to have to walk a couple of hours.
En ese momento ellos me dicen de que yo les digo de que no, ¿verdad? Porque yo ando con mi bebé y que tengo que cargarlo para caminar esas 2 horas y que no puedo yo sola.
So then I told them that I couldn't do it because I'm carrying my baby and I would have to walk with my baby in my arms and I wouldn't be able to walk for 2 hours like that and I couldn't do it alone.
Luego me dijeron ellos de que ellos se iban a turnar para poderme ayudar con el bebé. Entonces en ese momento digo, no sé, no tengo dinero, le digo yo a él. Entonces él me dice, no te preocupes por nada, yo lo voy a pagar. Pero él a las demás personas les estaba cobrando $1,500. Y sin embargo a mí me dijo de que no me cobraría nada.
So finally I said to him, well, I can't go because I have no money. And he said to me, well, look, I'll take care of it. And I knew he was charging the other people $1,500 apiece. So I thought it was strange because he was telling, you know, charging them $1,500 apiece and telling me he wasn't going to charge me anything.
Ya luego nos fuimos ese día y cruzamos muchos cerros aquí por Tecate y llegamos a un lugar que había un pantano, estaba crecido y donde ahí se tiran todos y están arriesgando la vida de mi hijo porque uno de ellos agarró a mi hijo y lo llevó con él. Entonces en ese momento yo les dije de que yo no iba a entrar al pantano, de que yo me iba a regresar.
So we were walking over a lot of hills, a very hilly area, and then finally we came to this bog, and it was very overgrown. And they took my child from me. They were risking my child's life. They were, you know, going to try to cross my child. And I told them, look, I am not going down into that bog. And
en ese momento él decide también regresarse conmigo y se regresaron otras personas. Pero su pensada de él, cuando ya veníamos ya en el camino, ya llegamos aquí a las instalaciones, ya su pago que él quería era de que yo tuviera relaciones íntimas con él. Era algo que no me lo esperaba.
Oh, my God, man.
So I turned back, and I wasn't the only one that turned back. There were several other people that didn't want to go anymore. And then he came with us. So when we got back to the shelter, then he told me what he wanted as his payment. He said he wanted to have sexual relations with me. And it was a shock. It wasn't something I was expecting.
Entonces, cuando yo le dije a él de que yo se lo agradecía mucho de haberme ayudado con mi hijo, pero que yo no iba a acceder a eso. Entonces, ya él ya fue ya cambiando ya su forma de ser hacia mí. Ya era ya más como odio. Ya él me miraba mal. Me decía cosas así feas, entonces ya yo corté la amistad así con él.
So after I told him no, and after that he completely changed the way that he acted toward me, and his treatment became hateful, and that's how he acts around me now.
Ya a los días él empezó a llevarse con las menores de edad, por las cuales el grupo que él se llevó ya después que él nos llevó a nosotros. Él para ganar ya su amistad les prestaba el teléfono, les traía detallitos, jugos, refrescos.
Then I noticed after this happened to me, he started befriending a group of minors, females. And he started to win them over, and the way that he would win them over was be to let them use his phone or bring them a Coke or some juice or other little details, other little presents.
Y ya llega el momento donde escuchamos de que se van, de que van a cruzar, de que él las va a llevar, y donde habían dos de que sí que estaban, que se iban, pero ya cuando él ya les dijo que les dijeran a las demás a ver si querían ellas irse también. Entonces así se fueron conforme y ya ajustaron un grupo ya de 5 o 6 personas.
So then, you know, these two of them started talking that concretely they wanted to go and they were going to go with him and he was going to take them, and he started to ask them to go around and ask the other girls who wanted to come with.
Bueno, pues salieron de aquí y todas alborotadas y todo porque se armó gran conflicto. Y en ese momento ellas agarraron un autobús que iba para el centro.
¿Por qué se armó el conflicto, sí?
Porque...
¿Puedes explicar eso?
Porque ya...
Why did the conflict start?
Yeah, because she said that there was a big conflict that started and they took a bus to the center of town. And I said, what was the conflict about?
Porque aquí en las instalaciones están prohibidos los polleros.
Oh, because there's no coyotes allowed here in the shelter.
Y en ese momento se estalló la bomba de que él la llevaba.
And the bomb landed, you know, that he was the coyote and he was the one crossing people.
Sí, ya cuando él ya se enteró de que tal vez alguien le avisó a él de que aquí estaba todos molestos porque él la llevaba.
When he found out that everyone here was angry with him because he was a coyote crossing people.
En ese momento él se regresa para las instalaciones como que no pasa nada, como para dar color de que no es él quien la lleva.
So he comes right back to the shelter and acts like he's welcome here and nothing's happened, kind of like to throw people off and make people think that he's not the coyote people were talking about.
Entonces las menores de edad se fueron hacia el centro, donde ya en el centro las racta una camioneta.
El coyote.
Era un contacto de él.
Okay, so they go to the center of town in the bus, the two girls, and they meet up with a guy that gets them a van. And I said, the coyote did? And she said, a contact of his. Go on.
Pues nosotros pensábamos aquí, como compartíamos la misma habitación, pensábamos de que tal vez ya ella ya estaba en inmigración, porque como eran menores de edad, Pero nos llevamos la sorpresa de que el siguiente día nos le cae una llamada a mi amiga donde le dice la tía que le puede ir a retirar un dinero porque su sobrina se va a regresar a su país.
So I get a call. I thought, we thought they were already, somebody picked them up because they're minors, you know, and I thought immigration picked them up or something. But it was a huge surprise to me that the next day I get a call from her aunt telling me that she needs me to do her a favor. She's going to send money for one of these girls because she's going to go back to Honduras. She got to go home.
Entonces, nos fuimos para el centro, mi amiga y yo. Nos fuimos a retirar el dinero. Y la encontramos a ella. Nos pusimos de acuerdo que nos íbamos a encontrar al frente de la iglesia católica que está en el centro.
So I went down there and I agreed to go and get the money for them. And I talked to them and I let them know we were going to meet up so I could give them the money. We agreed to meet in front of a church that's downtown.
En ese momento cuando la encontramos a ella, ella andaba nerviosa, estaba asustada y decía que se arrepentía de haberse salido de las instalaciones. Cuando nosotros le preguntamos qué es lo que pasa, ya ella nos dice de que desde que salieron de aquí y llegaron al centro, ahí la raptaron y iba un muchacho con ellas, al cual lo encerraron en un cuarto con llave y a ella la sacaron de la casa donde la habían llevado.
So she tells me she's really freaked out and she's very scared because after they left the shelter, they went to a building, a room. There was a guy that was with them. They took that guy, they locked him in the room, and they took the two girls.
They kidnapped her and on the vehicle, she was saying.
They kidnapped the two girls and took
in
them
a vehicle.
In a vehicle. Thank you, Pastor.
En ese momento ella nos dice de que se quería llevar solo a una menor con el bebé. Y entonces todas se como que se le revolvieron a los hombres que estaban ahí. Y ya al fin se llevaron al grupo de mujeres que eran las dos menores de edad y dos mayores de edad. Eran cuatro por todas.
At first they were only going to take the girl, the minor that has a baby. And they didn't want that. So in the end they ended up getting four girls together and they took four girls.
Cuando la sacaron de la casa, la llevaron a ella a buscar un hotel para ponerlas a ellas en un hotel.
When they left, they took them to put them up in a hotel.
Y la llevaban a uno, como que no les gustaba, la llevaban a otro, y nunca hallaban el hotel indicado.
So they took them to one hotel and they didn't like it. The girls, right? Las muchachas eran las que no querían quedarse.
No, ellos.
The coyotes didn't want to stay at that hotel, and then they would take them to a different hotel and say, no, we don't like this one either, and another one, and another one, and they seemed not to be able to find any hotel that they liked.
Llega el momento donde la llevan a la playa las cuatro mujeres. En ese momento no sé qué pasó ahí porque ya la muchacha ya no nos dijo nada más.
So they took them to the beach, and then I don't really know what happened to them during that part because the girl didn't talk anymore about what happened there.
Pasaron por un lugar sólido que estaba oscuro, y fue en el momento donde corrieron y las dos mayores de edad se escaparon, pero quedaron las dos menores de edad con ellos.
So they're dos mayores de edad.
Sí.
Two of the four women that they kidnapped were adults. The two minors were the ones that stayed with the coyotes, because what happened was that they touched solid ground at some point, and the two adult women took off running and escaped, and the two minors got left behind.
Entonces le decíamos a ella que regresara a la iglesia y ella dijo no, porque pueden regresar a buscarme. Entonces en ese momento la acompañamos a que agarrara un taxi para que ella agarrara el bus que iba para el DF y así agarrar los que seguían para Honduras.
So we told her, why don't you come back to the shelter? But she was too scared to come back to this shelter because she's afraid that the coyotes will come and look for her. So she asked us to take her to the bus station so that she could take a bus to Mexico City and then from there go back to her country. The end.
Okay, pregunta, una preguntita.
Question.
¿Has escuchado tus rumores de este hombre que ya se haya cruzado hacia los Estados Unidos?
Have you heard any rumors that this man, the coyote, has already crossed into the United States?
He escuchado de que dicen de que él se encuentra en un albergue en el centro, pero no sé realmente en qué albergue.
Actually, I've heard that he's staying at a shelter downtown, but I don't know what shelter.
¿Cómo te sientes tú de que las autoridades mexicanas no estén tomando esto con seriedad?
How do you feel about the Mexican authorities not taking this seriously?
Pues uno se designa porque se supone de que las autoridades están para protegerlos aún siendo inmigrantes.
It's very frustrating because I expected for the Mexican authorities to protect us even though we're immigrants.
¿Tienes miedo?
Sí.
Are you scared? Yeah.
Okay. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Uno más, mira, no más de un minuto.
No te van a señal tu boca.
No, está de abajo.
No, digo tu boca,
es de abajo. Es de abajo. Es
nomás de aquí para abajo.
Ya no quiero hacer la entrevista del tema.
¿Ya no quieres?
Ya, estás cansada. Okay. Sí, I'm sorry, man, we're asking the 50.
Ya me aburrí de entrevista aquí y al final no sé nada. ¿Por qué?
Esta es la prensa de Estados Unidos.
No te pongas así.
Esta es la prensa de Estados Unidos para que Estados Unidos presione al gobierno de México para que
She's
si
getting sad.
Algo,
the 15-year-old is not, you know, feeling well about the interview because she's
manera.
Saying that she's doing a lot of interviews and the authorities, nobody's
sí,
doing anything
prensa,
about it.
Pero de México, pero no de Estados Unidos.
Mira, nomás dame un minuto nada más. Si no quieres también, si no quieres está bien, pero nomás quiero que me digas tú en ese minuto que este canijo sí, te pidió.
¿Te propuso sexo?
Es que
a ti no, pero tú escuchaste que le propuso sexo a alguien más. ¿No?
No tengas miedo.
Ella quiso denunciar con la policía y las autoridades
She's
y no quiso tomar
guys.
Su declaración porque es menor de edad.
The pastor is saying that apparently she was the one that wanted to give declarations to the federal government, but the federal government didn't accept her declaration because she's a minor.
Y porque no tiene mamá y papá.
And because she doesn't have a mother and a father.
So
she's pregnant. ¿Cuántos meses tienes de embarazo? She's 8 months pregnant, you guys, and she's 15 years old. She's 15 years old.
No me había dado cuenta, por lo juro, por Dios.
Ahí traigo unas galletitas para ti. Para el antojo. I'm telling her that I have some cookies right there because she's pregnant, you guys. She's 15.
Ay,
and she's, ven.
No,
ven,
no,
siente aquí.
¿Qué voy a decir si yo no sé nada?
No, pues nomás.
De tu amiguita.
¿Qué edad tienes?
13.
Yeah, she's 13.
Okay. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Xiomara.
¿Xiomara?
Sí.
My name is Xiomara.
Okay. La pregunta que te quiero hacer es, ¿tú alguna vez escuchaste que este hombre se le ofreciera a una menor para cambio de sexo para cruzarla hacia los Estados Unidos?
Pues la verdad yo escuché cuando él le dijo a Jennifer que la iba a cruzar, pero no dijo que le iba por sexo, sino que le dijo que le iba a cobrar $500.
So the question that Oscar made was, so the question I have for you is, did you ever hear this coyote offer to have sex with any of your friends here in exchange for crossing them to the other side? She said, the truth is, I overheard him offer to cross Jennifer over to the other side, but he asked for payment from her.
That's the 14-year-old with no mom, no dad.
The one that I talked to her mom.
Yeah.
¿A ti se te ofreció también para que te cruzara?
Did he ever offer you to cross?
¿A tu hermana?
¿A tu hermana?
Did he offer your sister to cross? Yes, my sister.
Su hermana, her sister is the one that she's tired of talking because the authority is not doing anything about it. And this is this young girl right here, this 13-year-old has a sister that she's 15, the one that is pregnant. And we just asked her if she was offered to her sister too. Otra cosa más ya para no estarte preguntando cada rato lo mismo. ¿Cómo te viniste de Honduras para acá tú sola?
Del Salvador.
Pues
Del Salvador.
Ajá, vine a la caravana.
¿Tú sola? ¿Tu mamá
con
y tu papá dónde está?
Con mi hermana, vine. Sí,
¿Y se vinieron solas?
Sí.
¿Y no tienen miedo en venirse a esta de así?
No.
¿No tuvieron miedo?
No.
I just asked her, ¿tienes mamá y papá ya?
Sí.
¿Y les dijeron que se iban a venir? ¿Y los dejaron
sí,
venir?
Sí.
Sí.
¿Qué les dijeron sus papás?
Pues cuando nosotros venimos estábamos en Tapachula y le dijimos a mi mamá que ya lo íbamos a venir, dijo que estaba bien, que teníamos cuidado.
Okay, so Oscar asked, so how did you get here in the caravan? Who did you come with? My sister. Both of them are unaccompanied minors. She's sisters with a 15-year-old that's pregnant. She said, aren't you scared? Aren't you scared to come here by yourself? She said, no. And she said, he asked, do you have parents? She said, yes, my mom and dad. And then he asked her, do your parents know? She said, yeah, I called them and I told them I'm going with the caravan. They said, okay.
¿Qué fue lo que más te asustó o te dio miedo cuando viniste en la caravana?
What was the thing that scared you the most when you were in the caravan coming here?
Bueno, pues la caravana lo que más me asustó fue que en vez pues, se peleaban las personas o en vez fallecía gente y ellos se peleaban y así.
Se peleaban.
The thing that scared me the most, the pastor asked her what scared her the most when she was coming here in the caravan. And she said, oh my God. And then she giggled. And then she said, the thing that scared me the most is the fighting. There was some fighting. ¿Quién peleaba? Who fought?
Pues pelearon entre ellos mismos los...
The people that were in the caravan would fight each other.
Sí.
Les quiero hacer una pregunta a todos ustedes.
Pero también experimentaste que se robaron unos niños, ¿no? Se robaron.
Sí. You also saw some kids being kidnapped, didn't you? And she said, oh my God.
Sí.
Yes.
¿Cómo pasó eso?
¿Quiénes veías tú que se robaban estos niños?
Bueno, pues yo vi que robara, pero mexicanos se robaban a los niños.
Mexicans were stealing the children.
Wow.
¿En dónde? Where did this take place?
¿En dónde?
Pues no exactamente, no sé dónde fue, pero fue como mitad de la caravana. Como por Tonalá o por ahí.
Okay. ¿Han visto ustedes muchos de los MS-13 y MS-18 en la caravana?
Yo no viajé en la caravana.
I didn't travel in the caravan.
No, tú viste muchos de la ganga del MS-13, MS-18 en la caravana. I asked her if they saw MS-13s, MS-18s on the caravan. Okay, ya no voy a hacer más preguntas, pero creo que ya están bien como te dejo, Cindy, para que hagas preguntas.
Okay.
Sí.
Yo les quería hacer
una pregunta
yo acerca de lo que ustedes experimentaron.
I will put a right now. This right here.
Yes, check it.
That is the one on the left. It is the 13, 25, 27, and 15 pregnant right there. Okay, I will take a breather right here. I will let Cindy work. For a moment, I want to ask, my moderator, and I want to be real cleared with my audience. It's really disrespectful of the American audience attacking this interview, and it's extremely disrespectful of the American audience doing assumptions. These are minors that they are basically not advised, and their parents are extremely responsible. It's not their fault that they are so responsible that they don't advise their kids how to grow up and how to not to go in this caravan. So we will check this feed and every single person that did a hatred comment and every single person that did an awful comment or that did a comment that I consider that is disrespectful, it will be blocked. And immediately right now, I'm not playing around. You guys are so disrespectful. These are minors that they are being trafficked right now to the United States. These are minors that basically they are getting offered sex in exchange to cross illegally to the United States. We are reporting and we are doing a coverage on this story on these minors. If you don't like it, get the hell out of my feed right now. I'm not going to permit this. So please, moderators, please go on my feed right now, and after I finish this video, check the feed, please, and block all the comments, all of them, because I'm going to check the comments, and I will block all the comments that I think that they're hatred, and that I think that they're really stupid. I had it with some people in the American audience. It's unbelievable that you guys don't have not respect for minors. For minors. It's unbelievable. It doesn't matter if you're from Bangkok, Russia, Asia, they are minors. They are minors. They're unaccompanied minors.
Where's your education, people? Demonstrate your class.
We're right here live at the shelter with the pastor when we just saw practically evidence on these miners that basically they were offered to be crossed to the United States in exchange for sex or the amount of $1,500, and a lot of them 500 pesos, that is that is the amount of $26-$27, or 1,500 pesos, that is the amount around probably $80 to $90. So I'm located in Tijuana, Mexico right now, and I'm live right here, and it's not their fault. It's pretty saddening that I'm seeing on my country 60 million in poverty and 28 million in critical condition, and it will be saddening if I go to a particular place when there's Mexicans that they are suffering, and there's gonna be comments in my feed that they're gonna say this is because of your president. I saw some few comments, and I'm not going to interrupt the feed and to put attention to those particular comments, but I think that you guys, if you guys don't like the feed, and if you guys don't like the interview, get out, and that's it. Get out, really. There's a good comment right here, and I'm going to read it. The lack of education, the lack of responsibility, and the lack of responsibility from the parents in those countries provoked this. We still have communities like that in southern Mexico. Yes, we have a lot of them, and it's pretty, it's pretty irresponsible. There's no warning, Baldy. There's no warning, please. There's no warning anymore. Please go and find on the feed who did the disrespectful comments and blocked. There's no warnings. There's not going to be no warnings with me anymore. And if you don't like it, get out. Really, I'm not having no compassion. I'm a professional broadcaster. I take my job real seriously, and I'm not going to take disrespectful audience. So please, Baldy, just if you can do that for me. So we're live right here, people, and we're taking the, this interview, and this guy, what the rumor is that he's downtown in Tijuana, and he's still on the loose. So that is kind of preoccupying. Why? Because that means that he's still working, and that means that he's still, doing exactly the same thing. That means that the authorities are not doing anything about it. Yeah, it is. Means that the authorities are not up doing absolutely nothing about it. And that means that, specifically, no authority is giving a damn about these miners and, these people that they are practically asking miners for sex in exchange for them to cross illegally to the United States. Imagine that. So we just have the evidence right here. One of the miners, she doesn't want to talk. She almost cried on the feed. She doesn't want us to show her face or none of the above. Why? Because she's tired of giving declarations and tired of talking to the media, and the media is not resolving anything and nobody's doing anything about it. And what she wants is to feel secure. She's afraid now. Why? Because this trafficker is on the loose, and because this trafficker is on the loose, they're afraid for their lives, because this guy, as we know, a trafficker is involved with a cartel, or he is, collided with some organization that they are, crossing these people to the United States. One of them is 15 and she's pregnant. So we are going to continue this interview,
And let me see what kind of questions Cindy is asking. So please, moderator, if you see somebody with really comment out of line, please immediately blocked. It's not advise you or warning, it's blocked. Please, thank you so much. Have you been as
y me interesaría saber qué conoces sobre el asilo político. ¿Sabes qué tan difícil es?
This is a really good question. She's asking if they know something about political asylum. Adelante. No, 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 estoy
firmando.
Sí, sí, sí. No, no estoy firmando, estoy poniendo.
No te preocupes.
Sí, sí, yo sé que es difícil y es algo duro, pero el intento lo cuenta.
Pero ustedes saben qué es, cómo deben de pedir el asilo político. ¿Les dieron una instrucción o nomás les dijeron en Estados Unidos les van a dar la oportunidad de cruzar?
Es prácticamente lo que me dijo, que les iban a dar un número y que luego les van a dar asilo político.
¿O eso fue lo que dijo?
Sí, es lo que te lo perdiste. Sí. Entonces yo estaba preguntándole quién da fe de que te van a hacer ese proceso de esa manera. Me dicen que lo ponen en Facebook, que algunas personas que ya están allá, ya dicen ya estoy acá, pero no les han dado el asilo político. Esas
they're doing that
están
a lot of people
en
Guatemala.
Acá, tienen una cita, al igual que tú.
So practically, Cindy just asked a really important question to them, you guys. She asked them, do you guys know anything about the political asylum? And she said, no. And she said, so where, how do you get the information? And apparently she said that, they get information because of people going over there to Guatemala, and they're giving them numbers over in Guatemala. They're giving numbers for them and coaching them and telling them that their United States is going to give them an opportunity. Let me approach again the interview so we can translate.
No.
Cuando yo llegué aquí a la iglesia Agape, la mayoría de personas iban a sacar su número. Yo todavía estaba pensando, ¿lo saco o no lo saco? Pero llegué el momento en que lo fui a sacar. Esperé casi los 2 meses para entrar a migración. Y luego me dijeron, no me dijeron nada, de un solo, sin entrevista, sin nada, me dijeron de que miré el papeleo donde estaba que tenía que regresar a Tijuana. A los 2 días después de esa noticia que quizás ellos vieron, a los 2 días de que me regresaron a Tijuana, me volvieron a llamar, llamaron a mis familiares de Los Ángeles que me llamaran a mí, que me presentara la línea para ahí poderme entregar con ellos, que me iban a dar la pasada de un solo. Y se nos hizo raro y yo le pregunté varias veces a ella y eso le dijeron. Ella me decía, sí, me están llamando y llamando que vaya. Bueno, entonces el pastor me llevó ya como a las 6 de la tarde y me volvieron a hacer otra entrevista, el por qué yo tengo miedo de estar en Tijuana. Y ya a los 4 días me vuelven a tirar aquí a Tijuana.
¿Qué te preguntaron acerca del temor que tienes de estar aquí en Tijuana?
What did they ask you about, the fear of being you in Tijuana?
Sebastián.
¿Mande?
Lo mismo del señor Sebastián, lo que pasó con él, todo.
Okay. I'm talking about
¿y tú?
Nicolás Sebastián.
¿Tú también? ¿Te preguntaron sobre eso?
No.
¿No te preguntaron sobre eso? Y la misma pregunta para ti. ¿Te han platicado cuál es el proceso de asilo, qué tan difícil es obtenerlo y qué te puede pasar si no te lo dan?
Have they talked to you about the political asylum and the process?
Que dicen de que el asilo solo, si lo llegara a ganar, solo duran 5 años.
If you, they have told them that if they would win, if they will win the political asylum, they only grant for 5 years.
¿Qué porcentaje de personas que aplican para el asilo político?
Have they talked to you about how many of the percentage is positive for you to get the political asylum?
No.
No. Is she saying no?
¿Qué pensarías si te digo yo que en los Estados Unidos, y soy generosa, menos del 10% de las personas que aplican?
How do you think that I'm being generous?
I'll tell you the truth, that less than 10% of the people
generosa.
That are crossing legally to the United States claiming asylum get the political asylum.
Menos de 5% en general.
The exact amount is less than 5% that they get the political asylum.
Y actualmente bajo esta administración,
and actually under this administration, it's 3% that they're the ones that they're getting granted the political
asylum.
Pero
lo que yo no entiendo es por qué les están dando más prioridad a la gente que se está brincando al muro a las personas que estamos esperando el número.
The thing that I don't understand is why they're giving priorities to the people that they jump in the fence on the people that want to do things
porque
right, like me, that we're waiting
número,
for a number.
Hemos esperado más de dos meses.
But now we've been waiting for more than 2 months.
Es una muy buena pregunta, ¿verdad? Tú que, si tú tuvieras la oportunidad de preguntarle a un senador como el que vino a platicar con tu compañera aquí sobre cuál es la prioridad de las personas y por qué se les están dando.
Well, regarding the opportunity of the questions, what would you like to ask him?
Pues sí me gustaría hacerle esa pregunta.
I would like to ask him that
embargo,
question.
Sin embargo, yo se la hice al oficial que me entrevistó.
¿Qué te dijo?
I asked
the official
that interviewed me. Que me estaba haciendo.
And he didn't answer that question.
Ni siquiera escribió lo que tú le preguntaste.
And he didn't even write the question or what I said.
Qué gacho. Lo siento por ustedes, de veras sí.
I feel it real bad for you guys because this is not fair.
Les estén tratando de esa manera y ustedes están tratando de hacer las cosas correctamente, ¿verdad? Y encima han pasado un riesgo muy grande con lo que pasó con este señor.
Todavía tenemos el riesgo porque él está libre.
We also have the risk because he's free.
Aquí nosotros corremos peligro.
He's talking about Nicolás Sistema.
Tanto como nosotras como nuestros hijos.
Like us and like our children.
¿Qué edad tiene tu hijo?
How old is your kid? 7 years old. Both of them are real young. At the moment that I accused him, he said, I helped your kid. So he was trying to bribe you, emotionally bribe you to calm down. Saying yes. Have you ever received a threat by Nicolás Esteban?
Or
you're preoccupied to get out, to go out? We don't go out. We change phone numbers.
Nosotros no hemos recibido amenazas de él.
We haven't received no threats.
Sin embargo, fuimos a poner la denuncia hacia los policías que cambiaron el reporte.
Again,
y ellos
sí
han
department.
Estado viniendo, tomando fotos.
And they have been coming over here, the police department coming over here and take photographs.
Que se lo llevó a él.
And it's the same official that took him.
Y lo soltó.
And the same official that took Nicolás Esteban is the one that is coming over here to the shelter and take pictures. ¿Qué hace ese oficial cuando viene aquí? What does that official do
siempre
when he comes over
here? Llega un policía a chequear. Mm-hmm. Entonces, a veces cuando el policía viene a afirmar que todo esté bien, ya al rato él aparece en la patrulla. Él no se baja de la patrulla, él queda ahí en el carro, toma fotos, habla por teléfono.
So this official that got Nicolás Esteban is the one that is checking the shelter. This official that released Nicolás Esteban is the one that is coming over here and check the shelter. And he comes and he takes photos and he does the scouting on the shelter. Ya tienen ustedes iniciado su proceso de asilo político, ¿verdad?
Sí.
¿Desde hace cuánto?
Yo salí
How long ago has been you put the political asylum?
El lunes de esta semana salí yo de migración de nuevo. Me dejaron la corte para el 4 de junio.
So ya has estado en Estados Unidos ya.
Es que entré con el número.
Entró con el número.
Okay, so she entered you guys with the political asylum number. ¿Y cuánto tiempo duraste ya?
Prácticamente casi 8 días porque estuve 4 días y a los 2 días me volvieron a llamar y me tuvieron otros 4 días.
Más. She practically stayed there 8 days and they returned her back and they said no to the political asylum.
3 días.
And she went to court 3 days.
Y me dijeron que el 3 de mayo tenía.
And on the 23rd of May she has the next court date in the United States to claim for the political asylum.
¿No les dijeron qué tanto plazo de tiempo van a tener que esperar?
They did not tell you how much the time that you have to wait. They simply gave us paperwork and you're going to wait in court for it in Tijuana. That's simply. The 23rd of May, this young lady has court date. You haven't looked for a lawyer to help you guys with the process?
pero los cuales no contestan.
¿Nunca les han venido abogados de los...?
¿De qué lugar?
De San Diego, creo que son.
¿Pero qué organización?
No sé, son listas que los dan.
Para
que
¿listas?
Nosotros, ¿la tienen la lista?
Dan. Hay inmigración.
¿Dónde?
Inmigración nos dieron, o sea,
pero no les dan, no les dieron esa lista a ustedes físicamente.
Sí, lo dieron.
¿La tienes?
Sí,
la
tienes.
¿Me la traes?
¿La podemos ver?
Sí. There's a list of lawyers that the United States government gives to this immigrants for them to call these specific organizations. If we see a particular organization in that list, you guys know how the business is going about.
Usted ya
no te vamos a tener aquí mucho tiempo. Y ahorita, si quieres, para que no estés enfadada aquí, porque yo sé que ya te quieres ir.
Sí, ya se quiere ir, ella está cansada.
Ya estás cansada, ya estás bien harta de lo mismo.
Sí.
En pocas palabras, sí.
En pocas palabras, sí, ya me quiero.
No, está bien.
Descansa.
Ay, disculpe.
No. Ahí tengo unas galletitas de peanut butter, ya te las doy. Para que el antojo, porque has de traer antojos.
This is a 15-year-old, you guys. She's pregnant. Wow. She's 8 months, huh, Pastor?
8 months.
8 months pregnant. I just told her that I got some peanut butter cookies for her.
¿Cuánto tiempo conociste tú al coyote este chapín?
How long have you known this Guatemala trafficker? Since I came over here, he was right here.
¿Usted, Pastor, cuánto tiempo lo tuvo aquí? Dijo.
Pastor, how many months do you have him here?
Como desde fines de noviembre.
Since
November.
Late November.
Bastante tiempo estaba.
Long time.
Todavía no tiene orden de aprehensión. No tiene un police arrest.
They don't have a warrant for his arrest.
No han sabido nada de él. No se ha escuchado nada de él.
Aquí vive como unos 4 kilómetros de aquí. Está quedando aquí.
What? He's like 4 kilometers from here?
Kilómetros, yeah.
He lives here? The guy apparently lives right here, 4 kilometers away from this shelter. Nicolas Esteban lives here. Because he doesn't have a warrant for his arrest. He lives really close from here. Wow. We thought that he was... Wow.
You have to hide in the shelter.
Wow. And these women have to hide right here in the shelter. Wow. And he lives right here 4 kilometers from here?
Yeah.
Maybe three. And our government is not doing anything about it. So there's a list right now that they're going to show us from the lawyers. This is paperwork right here, so I'm going to change the camera right here to Cindy. And let's see the list of the lawyers. ¿Dónde está la lista?
Estos son los papeles que ellos me dieron. Creo que ese es...
This is the removal proceeding. Y...
Este es el mío. Este es el de mi hijo.
Okay.
Ahí está.
Record of sworn statement and administrative proceedings.
We're going to take pictures of this, people, so you guys can check it out later on the feed. And there's some questions that they asked the immigrants for the political asylum. And Cindy right now is taking full evidence of what is going on. ¿Dónde está la lista de los abogados? ¿Por ahí la tienen? Ahí está.
Son tres.
A ver, Cindy. Échamela. Here is the lawyer's list. Let's see if...
Damn, this is some tiny print.
Okay. ¿Te la leo, Cindy? ¿O tú la leas? Para el público.
Léelas.
Okay, this is the list of lawyers, people, that they are helping the immigrants. Catholic Charities of Los Angeles. Human Rights First. Legal Aid Foundation of Los Angeles, LAFLA. These are the three lists of pro bono legal service providers.
Can you please repeat that?
First one, Catholic Charities of Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. Second is Human Rights First. Third one is Legal Aid Foundation of Los Angeles. These are the three organizations that they're helping with the political asylum issue. Funny how this Catholic Charities, huh, Cindy?
Yeah, it was very interesting. I'm going to look into all of those because...
And I will take a picture of all these documents and... post them on the on our page so you guys can investigate. And we will eventually have list. All the evidence.
That is a short list.
¿Le estás tomando fotos a todos, Cindy?
Oh yeah.
Para que me las pases. ¿Sí?
Oh,
there's more.
Okay.
There's more lawyers right here. Okay. I will read the other one. This is Catholic Charities Diocese of San Diego. Oh my God, there's so many.
The SoCal Immigration Project.
Esperanza Immigration Rights Project. Chirla Coalition for Human Immigration Rights. Legal Aid Foundation of Los Angeles. Human Rights First. There's more right here on the back. Kids in Need Defense. Immigration Defenders of Law Center. Chirla again. Human Rights First, Esperanza Immigration Project, Legal Aid Foundation of California. It's the same one.
I've already featured kind on myself.
Okay, let me
see. Immigrant Defenders, check. Those are the people working with Mark Lane and Minority Humanitarian Foundation.
Yes. We have Casa Cornella Law Center.
Yep.
We have Jewish Family Service of San Diego.
There they are. Rapid response.
Rapid response. Jewish Family Service of San Diego. Right there. Ava Immigration Justice Project. Catholic Charities Diocese of San Diego again. Legal All Society of San Diego. These should be charged in the United States. Ava Immigration Justice Project. Jewish Family Service of San Diego. Legal Aid Society of San Diego, Catholic Charities of Diocese of San Diego.
This is a massive amount of money.
These people are making so much money. Asian Law Caucus, Asylum Program of the San Francisco Lawyers Committee Civil Rights, UC Davis School of Law, La Raza Centro Legal, Social Justice Collaborative. Another one is Community Legal Services in East Palo Alto. Kids in Need on Defense. Centro de Legal de la Raza. Central American Resource Centers of Northern California. Let's see if we got more right here. No, that's it. That's around it. Immigrants and claiming the asylum.
I will only use the text without your name, okay?
Raza, La Raza, R-A-S-A, or R-A-C-A, sorry.
Duke, could you give these two young ladies my card?
¿Tú estás tomándole todo, eh? ¿Las estás tomando todo?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, está bueno.
I am on it. I really would appreciate it if we could have these get a card if you have one of them.
So yeah, basically people, this is questions in the panel.
I'm almost done here.
Este es de donde vienes, ¿verdad? ¿El Chaparral? ¿Quién estaba en el Chaparral?
Las dos.
¿Las dos están en el Chaparral? ¿Las movieron del, del Benito Juárez también? ¿Para allá al Chaparral? ¿O llegaron al Chaparral ustedes?
Nosotros de aquí fuimos a sacar el número del Chaparral.
Ah, al Chaparral. Ah, es que ya lo daban, sí. ¿Nunca se toparon allá con uno que se llamaba al otro lado?
Los abogados.
¿Los abogados del otro lado?
Con los que tuvimos problemas de que casaron falsamente.
Pues a mí me dieron una tarjeta, pero yo les dije de que... Porque yo venía
¿La tienes esa tarjeta?
La tiramos.
No. Pero ¿qué querían contigo? Termina la
Él me dijo a mí de que ellos me podían ayudar con mi caso, pero como yo venía saliendo, yo les dije que no, que ahí después.
Sí. Ahí nos vemos. Cuando se acercaron a ti para ofrecerte ayuda, ¿aparecían esos vendedores de chicles?
Sí, andaban con una cartera así.
¿O tú los fuiste a buscar a ver qué venden o qué están aquí?
Andaban ellos con una cartera y andaban dando tarjetas. Entonces me dijeron, pero ten tu tarjeta, te la vamos aquí en el lado mexicano y en el lado de San Diego.
¿Cuáles son los planes para ustedes si no les dan el asilo político? What are the plans for you guys if you don't get political asylum?
Bueno, si en algún dado caso, porque si no nos dan el asilo, eso es de que nos van a deportar a nuestro país.
¿O se quieren quedar aquí en México?
Pues la verdad, no sé. No me he puesto a pensar en eso.
They haven't thought about it. They know if they deny the political asylum, they're going to be deported to their country. And I just told her that if they would...
¿Qué pasa?
Think about staying right here in the country of Mexico. And they say, yes, we will try. Pretty much, Cindy right now is letting her... Let them know that they're going to... have her a card, and for whatever information they need, Cindy. What does Gabby tell you, the one that escaped?
¿Quién es Gabby? Explícame bien quién es Gabby. Pero no se escaparon dos.
Pero Gaby queda, ¿Gaby es menor?
No, es cierto, una se regresó a Honduras y otra se quedó aquí.
Sí, Gaby tiene 22 años.
Gaby, she's 22 years old.
Es una muchacha de 22 años.
She escaped.
Ella se fue de aquí, me dice.
She escaped from here.
Mira, mejor que me maten en Honduras que no en Tijuana, porque en Honduras me pueden hallar mis familiares.
She preferred to escape from where she was kidnapped. And she said eventually that she will prefer to get killed in Honduras when she will be dying on her land to die over here in another country's land. So that's why she escaped and went to Honduras.
Muchísimas gracias, les agradezco las noticias. Que se hayan molestado tanto tiempo para darme el reporte. Les voy a dejar aquí mi tarjeta. Watch out, there's plastic on the floor, honey. Look up. levántalas.
Me lo trae en friega, Duke, todo el tiempo. Me lo trae en friega mi compa.
Ya las puedo dejar si quieren. ¿Puedo seguir con este pastor? ¿No?
So that's practically right now the interview that Cindy and myself did. As you can see, people wow. What kind of interview was that? I will come here tomorrow to do the Mexican public, and I will talk to them tomorrow with the Mexican public. I will come tomorrow or day after. I will come here on Monday probably. Today is Thursday, I think so. So I will come here on Monday for the Mexican public and for the Mexican public to know what is going on with this trafficking of children over here in this shelter. It is unbelievable. What we just saw, what we just witnessed is firsthand, people. Declarations from these young ladies that they, you know, people were charging them. $1,500, 500 pesos, $26, and there was different amounts. $1,500, $26, and the other one was less than $100, around $80 or $90.
and the one that is pregnant, the 15-year-old that is pregnant, she almost cried in the interview. She said it was really saddening to give another interview and the government is not doing anything about it. So the pastor just told us that Nicolas Esteban he lives 4 kilometers away from this shelter. Wow. This guy is loose. The government is not doing anything about it. And, the rumor was that he was in the United States. Now the pastor is giving us firsthand information that he's not in the United States. He's 4 kilometers away from the shelter. 4 kilometers away from the shelter. Imagine how insecure these people feel. Horrible situation, people. So it was really nice talking to you guys. We will give you guys a little bit of update. We'll talk to you guys in a minute, and we will do another live feed right now in the car with Cindy to get her opinion and to get her perception of what has happened right now. I will take some pictures of the documents right now. I had to go to work, people, so it was try to do the best interview that we can regarding this young immigrants, minors, and people that they are, that they are basically taken advantage of. Peace and love. I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News. Follow my partner, Conservative Anthony, and follow Cindy Gomez-Shemp and Dune Gomez-Shemp. We'll be right back. Stay safe. Peace and love. And always your country first.